Hello everyone and welcome to the first Infinite Galaxy free-to-play video. I created a new account to give all the players out there a little bit better idea of how to progress, what to do if you are a low spend or free-to-play player. I plan to make a video every day or at least every second day, give you a quick update, what I did, why I did it, so that you get an idea about how to progress. So right now I'm here directly after the tutorial. The first things I want to do is we need to get a research center. To get the research center, we can just click get it for free. So that's great as long as your build time is below 5 minutes, you just click there, get for free. So go through these things, get everything for free at the beginning. As soon as the time will get bigger, over 5 minutes, you will need to pay in Corium, but you will also see this. So we want to get our comment center up. So now we are at 6 minutes. Now we don't get it for free anymore. So let's look what other things we still can upgrade for free. So also the level of the building, the maximum level of the building is defined by the comment center. We got them now all besides this one on three, but to get the military dock we need to research the spaceport development handbook, or we have to do it. So let's quickly do that. We get our rewards from the main mission and get the final reward. The good thing is at the beginning you will have enough resources to do all of this, so you don't really need to worry about anything there. Okay, we have to follow a little bit tutorial again right now, unfortunately. Okay, so we will now directly start. We have everything already on level 2. We will just start already with the comment center level 3. We only have to wait 1 minute there, then we are at 5 minutes, and this will be where we can get it for free also. The first thing we want to get, okay, we have to follow for a moment the research there from the tutorial. Okay, so the tutorial will bring us automatically to the first mission here in the campaign. Campaign missions are usually or are always manual fights, but don't worry about this. All other fights will be automatic fights, so you only have to do a manual fight for these campaign missions. The good thing there is the first missions are very easy. You see here on the top right how many reinforcements you can get. On the top left you see the points and also the leadership for your reinforcements. I need 400 of these points here to call the next frigates in, and they would then require 30 leadership. So right now I don't have this. The missiles from your first flagship are always good to shoot them into a group of enemy frigates. I did this a little bit late this time, so I only hit the enemy destroyers. They are a little bit bigger ships, have more life, but same thing there. It's very easy. Here on top you also got the time, so you can accelerate it with by 2. Okay, the first research I want to go to is for Class 2 destroyers. To go there, I need to do Art of Spaceship Dispatch, and for the Art of Spaceship Dispatch, I will need Research Center level 5, and the level 1 warships. So this will be our first goal for the first day. We will go to get the Art of Spaceship Dispatch, then we will follow the Destroyer HP tree to get to the Griffin class destroyer. It won't take very long, it will be very quick to get there. As you see, to get to the next step, we only need the research center on level 4. So we can already start here. Just click the research, let it run in the background. The time for the comment center is below 5 minutes, so we can speed it up for free. We get it directly. We already know we need to upgrade the research center. Still below 5 minutes, we get it for free, so same thing there. We can quickly check everything that we can get for free, we will take for free. That is great. Free things are always appreciated. Also, this does increase your player power quite a lot. To progress here, we will need the next version of the comment center, 12 minutes to upgrade it. It needs deuterium. At the moment we don't have, so we can look at get more, and we don't have any resources in crates available right now. The easiest way to get these kind of resources at the beginning is to follow this main storyline, and then later you will just send out your fleets to gather these resources. Always keep an eye on events that are ongoing. Here we get some spaceport prestige points. They are required to hire new crew members. You can always check out my other videos. I do explain quite a lot of things there in detail on what are things, how do they work. Yeah, you should probably check these out. Also some beginner and starter guides. They will give you a better idea too. The first crew member you recruit will always be Helen Gremium. She's pretty good, so you want to keep her. You cannot anyhow sell them or anything, so as soon as you got them, they are yours. So to get your flagship, you always go to this right side. Here you can put equipment in. You can later, we will do this later, also build more equipment, and this will make your flagship also more powerful in the campaign fights. So I just click on 2x speed. This will make it much easier. We'll shoot our missile directly inside there. At the beginning, you don't really have to worry too much about this. You will be much, much stronger than the enemy, and you can just run through this. And I will also show you how to stay really strong, that you do not struggle with these campaign missions. So we start upgrading the command center to 4. This is always a requirement for our other buildings, so to upgrade research to 4, we need command center on 4. As we already got some corium, later I will show you what you can do with the corium. One of the best things to do at the beginning is to get a second building queue, so you can build twice as many buildings in the same time.
Thank you.
Okay, so you will always at the beginning find under the events like a main campaign. Sometimes you have to send your probes to investigate something. Sometimes, like just here, you have to send a crew member. Sending a crew member does not have any effect on your crew bonus, so you can always send whatever crew member you want to send, or the ones that you need to send to have the highest. Okay, so a few things I will do now and come back later in the next video. So first, I already explained to you the research I will do. I will go at the beginning to focus to get the Griffin Class 2 Destroyer level 1. This is my goal to get for the research. For the command center, I'm going to upgrade my command center as high as possible, followed by the research center, and I am going to look to upgrade my military dock, because your military dock, as soon as it hits level 7, will allow you to build two ships in parallel, two warships. So this will allow you to grow your strength twice as fast for warships. That's very, very important. The other buildings, I will just try to get them up also. As said before, we did get some corium here. We have 400 corium. This allows us to unlock the second building queue for one day, for 24 hours. So we will also do this. And now start to also upgrade the other buildings in parallel. As you can see here now, we do have both of them active, and this will give you some really nice quick advantage. We will also, as soon as we get, set up our fleet here that we can send it out. And for the events, if you click on events, you can investigate other systems. So you just click on the system and you send your probe there. This will give you additional resources, and many times these kind of resources will come in resource chests. So if you go to your depot, no matter from which screen, if you go to the depot, you see these resource chests here. You don't want to open them. Never open these resource chests. They will just increase the resources you have here. And one very important thing to know is you got a storage center here, which shows you how much of your resources are protected. Protected means they cannot be stolen by other players. As soon as you open all your resource boxes, you very likely will exceed this limit at one point, and then other players will very likely consider you a good target to attack to get more resources. And this is something you want to avoid under any cost. You don't want to get farmed by other players. If your resources at one point, let's see, we probably will get there. Yes, perfect. If your resources are too low, you see it here, they are red, and you want to build or upgrade something, you can click on get more, and then you do see the crates you have here, and the game already tells you how many crates you have to use to be able to build it. So you just click, in this case it's one, sometimes it will be two, five, ten. So the higher you get, the more you need. You click on this by one, you close this, and now you have enough resources to upgrade the building. This should be the only way you open these resource chests. Do not open them by going to your depot and manually open them. Only open them when you really need the resources to build something. That's probably the most important thing to note in this game. It is super important. It is really very, very important for you. If you waste your resources by opening them manually and then get attacked, as soon as your Comment center is above level 10 and we will get there very very quick. You will see this. Other players can attack you and then they can take away the resources that are not protected. Okay, so I think that's enough for the first video. I really hope that you will be able to use the information I give you here to progress fast and safe. If you want to speed something up, you can always check. You at the beginning, you got a few speed ups. So to get to 5 minutes, we don't need to get to zero. So we just get 2 of the 1 minute speed ups. Then we wait for the timer to count down below 5 minutes. Then we can do the free speed up. We don't need to spend any corium. That is free speed up. Perfect. We want to upgrade the military dock. You see here now both resources are too low, but if we click on upgrade, get more, we have to use 1 titanium. And here on the left side, you can switch the materials, 1 deuterium crate. Now we have enough resources, we can upgrade it. And we can continue our research here in the military tree. The same thing, we don't have enough resources. As said, you don't want to open these boxes manually. You get on, you get more. You click on however many crates you have to open to do the research. And this way you stay safe. You will always only use the crates for the resources that are missing. And also later you will get resources from other parts in the game. And yeah. So as said, also yeah, events, we did send our probe here. So now we can check, we can get the rewards there. You can always choose, I would prefer at the beginning always spaceport core modules. You want to get your core modules up as fast as possible. I do have a video also about these core modules and everything. So feel free to browse just through the other videos in this channel and get a better idea. Besides that, I will leave you now to this. The next video, probably tomorrow, we should be able to build tier 2 destroyers by then. We should have our flagship available to run some things. And we will see from there where to go. Have fun in the game. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and see you on the next video.